These days, with energy prices soaring, any way of minimising this cost is a number one priority, and the design stage is where many of the energy savings can be made. Leon Larson, a subsurface drip specialist with Darling Irrigation, explains how this can be achieved.
Good system design is important for any drip irrigation system, allowing for minimum pressure loss across the system. So small pressure savings equal long-term energy savings. So for people that don't have access to electricity and are running diesel engines, it's very important to find any small change that you can so that we can reduce the amount of diesel being used per megalitre of water.
So how have you achieved the pressure savings?
Pressure savings have been achieved by a couple of different ways. Increasing mainline size, sub-main size, so that we're reducing the amount of pressure we lose from our pump station to our drip line. Increasing the size of the drip line to reduce the amount of pressure we need to get water to the ends. And we've also introduced some new communication platforms into our irrigation controllers to allow for remote monitoring, most efficient selection of shift arrangements. Good communication platforms mean that we can operate our systems very efficiently so that we're reducing the amount of pressure loss through friction in our pipe. We've also introduced some new control technology just recently for diesel engines so that we can have the diesel engines running as variable speed drives. This increases the efficiencies by an average of 30%. So savings of 30% of diesel across our system during the summer months due to the fact that we can run the systems at lower pressure even though our filtration requires that higher pressure.